Morning, lovely souls. Happy Thursday. It's Tim Wild's Ascension Update, coming to you on a Thursday morning rather than a Friday morning, temporarily for the rest of November, because Diana Cooper and I are releasing the 10-day Ascension Boost videos that most of you will probably realise are coming to the page and to YouTube and via email, with the purpose of gathering lovely people onto our live event, our YouTube live. It's not a Facebook live, it's a YouTube live on the 1st of December. So yeah, details of that are available, or the sign up is available via our website. And I hope you're all well this morning. It's a beautiful day where I am, and I'm kind of grounding myself after an incredibly powerful event with Mia Kafkios last night, with from Grow by Mia, and we were working on the unification of the divine masculine, the divine feminine within the physical human persona that we are, and also setting the gold print, or the new blueprint for the future of the humans that we are going to be and that we are rapidly growing into. Because life is becoming different, our perspective is becoming different, everything around us is in the process of flux, it's in the process of change, there is a lot of movement, and there is a lot of pressure, and that pressure is being applied to create change. So, what I'm seeing a lot at the moment, as you know, I like to kind of base my Ascension updates on patterns of information, but also mostly on the questions that I am being asked the most. And just recently, or in the last month or so, I've spotted a run of posts, or a point of view, or direct questions regarding the souls that we are communicating with, and whether or not they are authentic and of the light. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my version of events forward, and who I trust and who I work with on a regular basis. And when I first, a little bit of my personal history, I began my ascension pathway a long time ago in the 90s, but my real ascension pathway began in 2008 after a life change, quite a big life change. And I was sat in meditation in 2008 when Archangel Michael, who I'd already become quite close to, as many of you will know, when you first step onto this pathway and you need guidance, you need protection, you need somebody there who feels like a friend, Archangel Michael is usually the soul, or the archangel, or the universal angel who is allocated to us as we begin that very broad and expansive kind of trip into the world of all things spiritual. So there I was meditating in my room, and with my eyes closed, everything kind of turned blue. Now, I'm not a highly visual person, as a lot of you may think that I am. I am clairsentient and I'm claircognizant, so I feel and I know, and I can count on the fingers of both my hands the times where I've actually been presented with something that I remember and I will remember for the rest of my life. So there was Archangel Michael speaking to me in my kind of semi-meditative state, telling me that I had a key role in this ascension process, that I was an Atlantean high priest many years ago, and that this was the time at which I was going to begin receiving my gifts back. And it was at that point he presented me with the blue star seal of Atlantis, which, if you go into my website, www.timwild.com, you can find the meditation. So, but the point of this is where I'm going with it is, this was my connection. This was my primary connection. It was Archangel Michael, closely followed by the Ascended Masters, Serapis Bey, Thoth, my higher self, and Archangel Metatron. And by pure instinct alone and pure guidance, these were the souls that I connected with. They lit me up. They guided me to the things that began to flow and fall into place and work in my life. And from that point onwards, I've never looked back. And of course, all of the other souls have introduced themselves as I've gone along, or I've read the information and deliberately connected with them, such as the dragons, the unicorns, the whole Atlantean collective. Everything that we kind of know and presented with, I've kind of dipped my toes into enough to know who they are, whether they are to be worked with, whether they're working for the planet, working for the light, and how to go about my everyday business with one foot in the everyday life that we experience and my other foot firmly planted in this spiritual realm, because that's what we're doing at the moment. We're marrying the two together and we're taking the best of what we had and moving it into 5D. Now, as we're entering the next 3 months or so, particularly December, January and February, we are going to see an increase in attempts to confuse and divide us. And this is very, this I believe is very important to address at the moment, because the questions that I'm receiving are we as light workers being deceived? Are we connecting to souls that actually work for the dark? And that we're all being conned and we're all being led down a pathway, and an actual fact that we are in the middle of this incredible simulation or illusion. And my answer to that is no, we're not. It's it would be almost impossible to take on the information that we are at the resonance that we are and moving forward in the group field that we are if we were being deceived on a mass level. Once we've woken up and once we've stepped up, once we've began to remove that veil from the third eye, everything becomes very clear. And one of the things that I've been gifted with is a very clear perception of what's happening on this planet and where we've been, where we've come from, the things that we've experienced and why we've experienced them. So in the process of detaching from the control matrix, from 3D, in which, for want of a better description, it is a school, it is a dimension of illusion. In order to maintain 3D, as you've heard me say before, we've had to be in a state where we believe we're limited and that our connection to spirit is limited. It's something that we have to work with. So when we eventually raise our vibration and we step onto this pathway, the correct souls begin to come to us. And that is something that we automatically and instinctively trust. And we do so because of the way that we respond physically, mentally, emotionally and spiritually. What we are being asked to do is begin to, what the 3D matrix is trying to do at the moment is sow doubt upon our own convictions and also sow doubt upon those that have actually been allocated to us to assist with this process, to move us through it, to go from one state of vibration, which was low and very limited and very kind of very, very shielded, into a state of illumination where we are connected to our heart centers rather than our egos. So we're at this critical point right in the middle at the moment, and every single little piece of information that will confuse and divide us is now being thrown, and it's going to increase. Okay, so this is what I'm kind of saying at the moment. If you haven't had your discernment tested on this ascension pathway yet, it's highly likely that you will either be having it tested at this moment and this will be resonating with you, or it's going to be something that will come forward and present itself to you in the very near future. So here's a few little examples of the things that I've heard, and they're not new. They're ideas that have been circulating for a while. The first one is that the concept of chakras within the body is completely, it's an illusion. We don't need them. They're actually kind of used to siphon off our energy and trap us in a certain dimensional space. First of all, I don't believe that. That does not resonate with me. Okay. We are of a physical, I see us as a physical blueprint, physical, mental, emotional, spiritual. and the chakras comprise the energy body, the energy nexus points within us that we communicate with our reality, or we're connected to our reality. We've gone from 7 to 12 quite recently, within the last 6 years or so, and are in the process of integrating another higher three. So all of this is, we are in a process of expansion. So the concept to me that we don't need these energy centers, the chakras, and that we're in actual fact we're being kind of blindsided or led down a garden path, to me that's nonsense. It's not my, that's not my reality. It's not how it works. It's not how it feels right to me. It's never been the way that I have, taking on that information would not move me forward in any way, shape or form. So that's the first one off the checklist. The second one is that the archangels, particularly Archangel Metatron, maybe Archangel Michael as well, are actually working for the dark. And in actual fact, anybody who connects to their energy is being, they're having their vibration lowered, they're moving into from one state of illusion into another. Again, this is a field of speculation or belief that has been kind of sewn in quite recently. And I can see why it's being done, because those that present themselves to us first and are orchestrating and managing this ascension process to kind of, put doubt into their abilities and what they are doing at the moment is a very effective way of seeding doubt and division within ourselves. So even though I did stop and look and see where this information is coming from and where what the potential for it is, again, I struck it off as not being for me. That is definitely not anything that feels right in any way, shape or form. The other one was that the Atlanteans were all bad, okay? And even to the point where they're kind of like part of a cult. Well, one of the things that we need to remember is that at the fall of Atlantis, there were some very good Atlanteans and there were some very bad ones. Okay, pretty much like we've got on the planet at the moment. It's a divided reality. Got people who are trying to maintain and bring in the light and usher this ascension process through as smoothly as possible. We've got a group of souls who've been in place since the fall of Atlantis, are doing absolutely everything within their capabilities to prevent that from happening. And so this kind of North and South Mars and Venus divide has been in place for a long time, over 10,000 years. But I can see where these ideas come from, because a lot of us did have bad experiences at the fall of Atlantis. But there are a very powerful group of souls awake and awakening on this planet at the moment, who have identified as that with that Atlantean connection, and they are key in bringing this ascension process forwards. So again, to sow seeds of doubt into that particular field of knowledge and energy is an effective way to halt the process, if you see where I'm going with this. And also, just anything at the moment that you are presented with that causes confusion or brings a state of doubt or fear within you, look very closely at that information and why it's been presented to you. And this will be prevalent. It will be coming through the media. Not that I watch the media, and I know most of you probably don't, because we switched off from it quite a considerable period of time ago. But also social media and people that you may have trusted as teachers previously are suddenly adopting this role. They're going through stuff themselves. What I think is a useful thing to remember for all of us is that even, you know, people that you may have regarded as a teacher, put them on a pedestal previously, they are human beings, okay? They're subject to the same process and the same stresses and strains and flexes and distortions of reality that you are, okay? It's just the fact they might have gone through a set of protocols before you in order to learn what they've learned and then chosen to teach and present. So everybody is now on a level playing field, and we're all being tested and put through our motions in the same way. And the purpose behind that is to get us in position and get us working, get us strong and grounded in our foundations and our faith systems, our belief systems, what we wish to create and what we are using to create that on a very strong level. So it's almost like you raise your vibration, you go through the things that you go through, and then you will be tested upon that. Okay, you'll be tested upon that foundation, what you have created for yourself. It's almost like putting up a new set of gates on your castle. All of a sudden somebody starts ramming the gates to make sure that they remain secure, and that your fortress is surrounded by stability. So this is an ongoing process. A lot of people have gone through very intensive discernment tests over the years, and all of a sudden they find themselves going through it again. It's, well, okay, you passed it the first time. They're just making sure that you are able to distinguish truth from illusion in your own personal reality. It's each test is incredibly personal. We've all got our own personal truths. We've all got our own personal realities, but we're all also paradoxically unified in this ascension process, having decided that we are going to participate in it. So it's a quite a complex state of affairs. And so just, it's going to be a case of very much self-managing what you are receiving over the next coming months, because the way that I feel that this is going to be approached, the way that I feel that we are going to be tested at the moment, is by shaking the foundations of what we thought was secure. And it's an ideal way to bring us back into a state of self-doubt and also to divide us. Okay, division is the one thing that will put us backwards on this ascension process at the moment. Dividing our kind of ranks, so to speak, and causing self-doubt and fear within ourselves immediately knocks us backwards. You know, the second we start doubting our sources, start doubting ourselves, start doubting our guides or our angels or those that have assisted us and helped us along the ascension pathway, that is at the point where we need to kind of stop, recalibrate, assess the information that we're being given, and move forwards as smoothly and quickly as possible. Because we are, I wouldn't say we're on a time limit, but there is a window that we are in at the moment that is being pushed very hard. Okay, so if you're looking at the vibration that is coming in from the cosmos, every single day that we're on this planet at the moment, the vibration rises. So we are being pushed. Okay, just as we believe or we feel that we've been integrated an incredible amount of light, we might have even been physically ill or something in order to integrate that light, or we might have kind of gone through an emotional release, a complete rebooting or remapping of our energy systems, there will be another one. But each time it occurs, we'll be more fluid and we'll be more used to and able to integrate that next phase of the light. There's a lot of people I know at the moment that are almost being physically remapped, okay? And which goes a little bit beyond the ascension symptoms, like the headaches or the blurry eyes or the dizziness or the fatigue. And these particular kind of remappings or upgrades make you physically poorly, like or physically unwell, displaying physical illness symptoms like I did in August. And some of them are very intense at the moment. Now, I don't know if for those of you that have been following me for a while, you remember me talking in July about the flood of walk-ins coming in. Okay, now a walk-in is a high frequency soul or a much higher frequency version of yourself that connects. Okay, most of us are receiving aspects of our higher self that are way above the benchmark of that we're used to. And when we suddenly take that energy in, everything kind of shuts down, cleans out what isn't necessary, reboots the system, a bit like turning the electrical system off, rewiring it all and then booting it back on again. But in some particular cases, it really, really pushes the physical body, and the physical body has to rest, okay? So some of you might be experiencing that at the moment. Others of you might know somebody who's experiencing that. I certainly do. So it's a very interesting time. It's a challenging time that we're experiencing. And I've always said that November is it's an action month. It's the month that we're kind of being prepared for December, the winter solstice, or the winter solstice in the Northern Hemisphere, the summer in the South. So just be aware of what is coming in. Be aware that you might be presented with people that have taken something on that conflicts with your belief, and they are trying to present it to you as being the urgent reality. You must believe this. Save your skin, save your soul, believe what I'm telling you, all of this kind of stuff. Always listen to what's being presented to you, but be very choosy about what you're taking in, the information. Assess how it resonates with your body. Does it create happiness and a higher vibration? Does it light you up? Or does it drop your vibration, cause confusion, self-doubt, fear, and ultimately division in what we're doing? Okay. So that is pretty much what I'm looking at the moment. I mean, there's other examples of it as well. The main kind of theme of it seems to be we've been tricked, and no, we haven't been tricked. There's we're very much aware of where we're going. It's just sometimes pretty challenging to achieve what we're trying to achieve at the moment in the dimensional space that we are operating with. On the other end of it, when we've got where we're intending to go, things are going to become very different, a lot smoother and a lot easier to function in, even to the point where some of those that have been warriors for a very long time, and we've been very challenged, and we're used to the grind, we're used to the fight, some of us are going to find that in itself quite difficult to navigate, because all of a sudden we've got nothing to face up against. We've got nothing to deal with. We've got nothing to process. We just have to live in a state of love. That's where we're going. Okay, but I'll be covering that subject, which is very in-depth and very interesting, another time. You know, what happens when we get there? Have any of you ever thought about that? What happens when we get to our target? Do we just stop and go on holiday? Or do we continue with another project? Do we continue creating? I thought about this for myself because I'm very driven. Okay, I kind of thrive on the drive and the grind. And this, particularly this last 2 years or so, has kept me very buoyant. The period leading up to 2019, 2020, I was definitely getting itchy feet. I was like, come on, when's the fun going to start? Give me something to get my teeth into. And then all of a sudden it all kicks off and it's like a kid in a candy shop. So this is something to think about. When we do eventually get presented with a reality that is peaceful and calm and harmonious and filled with love and light and unity, a lot of us are going to have to deprogram from what we've experienced. Okay, all of us are warriors. You're a warrior listening to this, tuning into this. You're an earth warrior. You've incarnated at a very special time, but you've done so with a toolkit or a skill set that is specifically moulded to this part of the ascension process. So we're going to have to remap and relax at some point in this procedure. And I think it's a good idea to begin to adopt that now. A lot of us are creating a kind of like an agitated reality just by simply expecting the hammer to drop. It's food for thought. Sending you loads of love. Now, I hope you have a beautiful Thursday, Friday, weekend, and I'll see you again next week. Bye for now.